Good evening, students. Today we'll be discussing something about electric field lines. So before starting with electric field lines, I want to discuss something related to electric field first. As I've already explained to you in my previous video about electric field, that electric field is a region or space of a charged body, around the charged body, within which its influence can be felt by some other charged body. So in order to depict the electric field of a charged particle, we usually draw some lines, and those lines are known as electric field lines. Now, the definition of electric field lines, as you can see here in the pink line, electric field lines are the straight or curved imaginary lines in a region such that the tangent at any point of the field gives the direction of electric field at that point in the region. So what you will get from this, that electric field lines can be straight or curved, and such that tangent at any point gives the direction of electric field lines means, suppose you are having this kind of electric field, and if you will draw a tangent at this point, you will get the direction for your electric field. So here, as already told you, that electric field lines are means of representing electric field pictorically. So if I want to show electric field pictorically, I'll be taking help of electric field lines. So this is basically a theoretical concept which was actually introduced by Faraday. Now I'll show you one example here. Just look at the diagram carefully. Here is the first diagram. Here is the charge plus Q. It says Q is greater than zero, which means, of course, Q is positive. And here you can say in the B diagram, the Q is greater than zero. So this is again a positive charge, as you can see here as well. And in the third diagram, it is written that Q is less than zero. If Q is less than zero, that means it will be negative charge. Now you have to notice one thing here, Vita, that here in the first situation, the arrows, the density of the arrow is more, and the arrow are basically pointing outward. So for the positive charge, the arrow will always be outward. Here is again the positive charge, so arrows will be outward. To show the electric field of a positive line, positive charge, electric field lines will be outward. And here in this diagram, you can see here the negative sign, and the arrows are in the inward direction. So in order to depict the electric field lines for the negative charge, you have to draw the arrows, I mean the lines and the arrows, in the inward direction. And if I want to compare these two diagrams, so what is the basic difference in these two diagrams? Here the arrows, number of arrows is more, which indicates that the density of your electric field is more. Or you can say that the magnitude of electric field is more as compared to this case. And I will read this thing for you here. So here we have, consider a charge plus Q given in a sphere as in diagram 26A. Now if we place a unit positive charge in a space around the charge Q, it will experience a repulsive force radially outward. So the arrows indicate the intensity of, as I told you, that the arrows indicate the intensity of charge Q at different points. So the size of arrow is proportional to the intensity of field at that point. While the direction of arrow indicates the direction of force of the unit positive charge, or the direction of electric field lines. So you will keep in your mind, for positive charge, the lines will be radially outward, and for the negative charge, lines will be radially inward. Hopefully this section is clear to you. So here is the electric field lines for the negative charge, and they have written that they have directions radially inwards. Now one important point is here in the diagram 28. You can see here. Here it is a plus Q1 charge, and of course here is plus Q charge. So now I'm having two charges. You can see these curved lines, and because this is a positive charge, so the electric field lines are actually outward. So I have drawn all the, you know, you can see here the direction of the field lines in the outward. And you can see here the end point, which is basically your neutral point. Here they have taken two different situations. One is QL and other is QS. Now I will read this for you here. It says electric field lines for two equal positive point charges and for two equal
unequal positive charges are shown. Here it is equal charge, so that's why it is written QS is equals to QL. And here it is unequal charge, so that's why it's mentioned here QS is less than QL. So you can see here for QS, as QS is less, so it has less field, and QL is greater, so it is having more field. And in the third situation, you can see the two different charges, one is positive and other is negative. Many a times these diagrams are asked in one mark question. So I'll read it from here again for you. In figure 28, the point N represents the neutral point. Here N, where no field lines are there, you can call this as neutral point. Why we are calling it as neutral point? Because the net electric field intensity due to the charges is zero at this particular point. So neutral point lies always at the exact middle of the distance between two similar and equal charges. So this is the middle point actually. And wherein this case, in second case, in which you have two unequal magnitude charges. So the neutral point will lie closer to the smaller of the charge. So this is the smaller charge, QS smaller. So neutral point is lying towards the, or you can say it lies closer to the smaller of two charges. And if the charges are unequal, you can see the diagram is like this. Because the electric field lines starts from positive and end at negative. So it starts from positive and end at negative. So you can see this type of diagram here. But for the positive charge, it is outward. So the direction is outward from here. But for the negative charge, it's inward. So these the downward arrows are in the inward direction. And what about these arrows? Actually, I told you that electric field lines start from positive and end at negative, so that's why is the arrow is pointing in this direction. And now we'll be discussing something about types of electric field. So we are having two type of electric fields. One is uniform and other is non-uniform electric field. So a uniform electric field is represented by straight, equally spaced parallel lines as shown in this diagram. You can see the equal spacing. So this is basically your uniform electric field. And then we have again here the electric field produced by the two equally and oppositely charged and close spaced parallel line is uniform. So the field produced by thin uniformly charged infinite sheet is also uniform. So they have given one example here, the example of sheet, in which they want to show the uniform electric field. Now what about non-uniform electric field? The non-uniform electric field of an isolated charge is represented by the field lines which are radial and not parallel, as I have shown you in diagram 33. So this is your 33rd diagram, which is a non-uniform field, you can say. Hopefully now electric field lines and type of electric field is clear to you. So thank you so much for watching.